Hello and welcome to Northwestern News Report. I'm Karleigh Stone. Today, a Black Lives Matter march in Washington Park today after Jason Van Dyke was sentenced last week. Shannon Longworth has the details.
But it's a double-edged sword. Genuine leather is much better for the environment, but animal rights activists say it's cruel. The aquarium offers a quiet room for guests needing to take a break. Additionally, the sensory-friendly app has a map of locations that might be hard for people bothered by loud noises. That way, you know what you're getting into before you go.
To jog your memory, Special Counsel Robert Mueller investigated Russian government interference with possible conspiracy by President Trump and his associates in the 2016 election. Attorney General William Barr released only a four-page document detailing the report at the end of March that left the DOJ, Democrats, and the American people wanting more.
Professional softball salaries in Chicago range from $6,000 to $20,000 a year, according to the Bandits players I spoke with. This is a stark contrast to what baseball players are making inside Wrigley Field. Last year, the Cubs' highest paid player, Jason Hayward, made over $28 million, and the team's lowest payout, still over $500,000.
The measles outbreak continues to spread across the U.S. with near record-breaking numbers. 626 cases have been reported so far.
Michigan Avenue is bustling with shoppers, racing to find fashion's next hot trend. In what's known as fast fashion, retailers rapidly produce inexpensive clothing that matches the latest styles. But it has consequences, many of which affect the environment. But 25-year-old Jill Nachel chooses to thrift shop instead as a means of recycling clothing by buying used.
I've been thrifting for many years. I focus less on fast fashion. I focus more on kind of style and things that will stay in my closet for a long time. So for example, this jacket was $10 at Goodwill, and it's from Express. So many different things that you can do with just repurposing and reusing.
The fashion industry is responsible for 10% of global carbon emissions, 20% of global wastewater, and a large amount of ocean plastic pollution.
Thrifting is so important for the environment. We keep 700 million pounds of clothing out of the landfills every year. There's so many things that come in here that are even brand new.
In addition to shopping sustainably,
Nachel has taken her thrift shopping talents and turned it into a career. She currently has an Etsy shop called Shop Alice.
I started repurposing clothes. I taught myself how to sew. I was doing a lot of patchwork on denim.
It's like totally a part of her identity that is like evident.
The average piece of clothing takes 20 to 200 years to biodegrade. So next time you're adding to your wardrobe, consider thrifting as an option to reuse and recycle. And like Jill Nachel says,
let the pieces find you.
In Orland Park, Karleigh Stone, Medill Reports.
Today, the aftermath of Sunday's deadly explosions in Sri Lanka. The measles outbreak continues, and President Trump threatens to sue House Democrats.
The Chicago mayoral election is tonight. Issues facing the city's next leader are gun violence, budget, education, and housing.
Almost 300 people are dead and over 500 more injured in explosions that occurred on Easter Sunday in Sri Lanka.
In sports news, the weather's been warming up and Major League Baseball fans are coming out of hibernation. Both the Cubs and the Sox are 5-9, but baseball's not the only thing that's back. Chicago's professional softball team, the Bandits, are gearing up for opening weekend.
President Trump is on a mission to block Democrats from obtaining his financial records. He filed a lawsuit against the House Oversight Committee after a subpoena was issued to his accounting firm.
In other news, R. Kelly failed to appear in court in Chicago yesterday and by default lost a civil suit. The alleged victim accused Kelly of having sex with her multiple times as a minor. The Cook County judge will assess the damages over the next month.